Hello and welcome back to Investment Vitals. There has been an important development in the ongoing FTX claim case, which can have major bearing on the amount that we might recover from the now infamous and defunct cryptocurrency exchange, FTX. I will be providing the highlights and key updates from this development in this particular video. Subsequently, I will make a detailed video on the entire docket that was released for those who might have interest in this development. However, for most mall customers of FTX, this video should be sufficient enough for an update purpose. If you find this video useful, please like the video and share it with your friends and family so that many people can benefit out of this. Also, subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to stay updated of developments in the case, specifically those which might require urgent and important action from your side. If you have any input, suggestions, queries, or feedback, do mention it in the comment section and I will try to come back to you as soon as possible. Before I proceed, I'm neither a legal nor a financial advisor. So nothing contained in this video or on my channel is legal or financial advice. Now with that out of the way, let me start with the development here. This development is the proposed settlement of customer property dispute. Now, this might sound a little confusing, so I'll remove the legal jargons and I'll try to simplify as much as possible. The claim, the current proposal pertains to the settlement of customer of FTX assets. Now, FTX assets, which went defunct and filed for bankruptcy, had payables to many people, including the customers. We had a cryptocurrency and money on the exchange, which has to be paid back to us. Similarly, the current cryptocurrency exchange had certain penalties and taxes to be paid to the government. Also, there were many suppliers. For example, people who might have given computers, provide computers or supplies to FTX for which they were not paid. So there are many set of people who have a claim on FTX and its assets. Of course, obviously, many of these people were having dispute on how should the assets of FTX be distributed among all the claimants. The current proposed settlement is an attempt to resolve this dispute. And indeed, it's a positive development for the customers of FTX because this particular proposal now prioritizes the customers over all other unsecured creditors, which implies that we will get a preference when it comes to getting money out of FTX vis-a-vis the other creditors. I'll be giving details of this as we proceed in this video going forward. This document also specifies that customers expect to receive over 90% of distributable value worldwide if the amended plan is approved. Now, I have seen videos across on various other forums wherein people are believing that customers would receive more than 90% of the claim. Well, that is not what the intention of this line is. The document specifies that out of the total assets of FTX, which is directly attributable to the exchange, around 90% of that will be made available to customers of FTX, and the balance 10% would be available for other creditors like government for tax payments and the other vendors, etc., etc. I will also move the document. I will go through the titles here. It says that FTX trading and its affiliated debtors today announced the proposed settlement of customer property dispute in the pending Chapter 11 case, which I discussed some time back. One important development here is it specifies that this is expected to be concluded by the second quarter of 2024. I will make another video on the timelines which is proposed in the docket. But for this purpose of this video, the plan is expected to be concluded by 1st of July 2024. If everything goes as per plan, as envisaged in this document, we can expect to get our money back on the 1st of July 2024. And that will be a major achievement. FTX collapse was a huge collapse, which had many stakeholders and claimants, including customers. So if a resolution is achieved by 1st of July, it will be a milestone. It will be a massive achievement for the team handling it. I know that the team has been working extremely hard on this. And if it does fructify on 1st of July, it will be a fantastic achievement. However, let's keep our hopes a little limited, constrained, because in such complicated cases, there is likelihood that it might get stretched beyond what is envisaged right now. However, if it gets concluded on 1st of July, it will be fantastic development for all of us. The next line, I'll read through the line first and then explain the meaning thereof. It says, the customer property litigation asserted that customers of FTX.com and FTX US have property interest in certain assets rather than an unsecured claim ranking equally with general creditors. The customer shortfall settlement resolves the dispute by providing customers a claim against FTX debtors that, although unsecured, has an equitable priority to certain properties segregated at or token from the exchange. Do not get confused with this. I will simplify this. What this basically says is, ordinarily speaking, we were unsecured depositors with FTX, and therefore we would normally have a priority equal to other claimants. However, in this document, the entity is trying to provide is has proposed that customers will get a priority and will get the money back earlier. This will get clearer when we move in the further part of the document, wherein the plan of organization is mentioned. Now, the plan of organization, I'll read through it first and I'll explain it further later. FTX debtors would divide substantially all of their assets into three pools. So I'll first provide an explanation to that before reading forward. In this plan, it is proposed that three pools will be created. The first pool will be FTX.com, which essentially are the international customers of FTX. The second pool would be FTX US, which essentially are the US residents who are using the FTX.us portal for the cryptocurrency exchange. And the third would be a general pool, which will include all other claimants, say government taxes, vendors, so on and so forth. Now, subscribers of the video already know that there were other type of customers also, like FTX Europe, FTX Japan, so on and so forth. As we discussed in the other videos, these probably are getting treated in other court case and hence are not covered in this current document. I'll move ahead with the further discussion herein. As I said, the treatment of customers of FTX.com, essentially the international customers of FTX, will be different from treatment of FTX.us. Now, this gets highlighted in point number three below. I'll be coming back to point number two for greater discussion, but point number three becomes important in this context. The company would be, I'll rather go to point number two first. The company would be segregating assets that are directly attributable or directly linked to FTX.com for the purpose of customers of FTX.com. Similarly, it will identify and keep aside assets that were exclusively identifiable with FTX US for customers of FTX US alone. And a third pool would be created out of those assets which are neither directly linked to FTX.com nor directly to FTX US. So that will be kept in the third pool for general pool. I will be discussing subsequently that we also will have a claim on the general pool in a good proportion. However, the third point becomes important, which says that shortfall claim is estimated to be approximately $8.9 billion for FTX.com customers and a mere $166 million for customers of FTX US, which implies that the shortfall in the amount being claimed and the amount actually apportionable for customers of FTX.com is $8.9 billion, which is a huge amount. Compared to that, FTX US has a smaller amount. As is also discussed in the later part of this document, it is fairly clear that FTX.com customers might have to take a slightly bigger hit or a loss compared to FTX US customers. Again, this I'll discuss in greater details at later portion and also in a detailed video subsequently. Further, it says, as I mentioned some time back, we will also have a claim on the general pool. The document proposes that out of this general pool that is available, which is not directly linked to either FTX.com or FTX US, out of the general pool available, the 66% of that would be directly linked to customers of FTX.com and FTX US. And only 34% of the balance amount from the general pool will be made available to other creditors. This is also a very big positive for existing customers of FTX.com as well as FTX US. Furthermore, as I said some time back, the FTX debtors, that is the company, essentially currently anticipates that customers of both exchange will not be paid in full with greater percentage of losses by customers of FTX.com. Of course, considering that the shortfall is in billions for FTX.com and only millions for FTX US, the amount of loss can be expected to be higher for FTX.com customers. However, as I've discussed in my previous video, which a link of which is appearing on the screen right now, we can actually expect to get 100% of money back considering the investment that FTX had in various illiquid assets like Anthropic. This has also been covered in greater details in the document. I will also provide a little brief of this subsequently in this video, but I'll give greater amount of details when I make a full detailed video of the document released. This is predominantly the key highlights of the video. Also, the video has certain other important discussions. First of all, okay, let me reiterate that FTX.com assets will be exclusively marked for FTX.com customers. FTX US assets will be marked for FTX US customers. And a general pool will be created, over 60% of which will be allocated first to the customers of FTX.com and FTX US respectively. Not mentioned in this current summary is the treatment of FTT token. It is covered in the detailed document, but I'll provide a glimpse to it. The current proposal envisages that FTT tokens will be extinguished, essentially meaning the holders or people who held FTT token will not be paid anything out of in this current settlement proposal. Now, this could include people who are holding FTT token on FTX or its linked exchanges, or also on other exchanges, let's presume Binance and all. So if you are a holder of FTX FTT token, unfortunately, there's small bad amount of news for you. You might not be considered for the amount of FTT token might be considered as zero for the purpose of your settlement. I'm really sorry for you if you had FTT token, but this is what it is currently proposed. Also, it is specified in the document, in the detailed docket, that the settlement should be made on US dollars, dollar basis. So the subscribers of this video already know this. Link above is the video in which we had discussed in the queries that was raised earlier, that the probability of us being settled is higher to be in US dollars given the previous decisions that were made by the court in this context. Also not covered in the summary currently is a discussion on the convenient class, essentially wherein the small customers of FTX will be given a certain preferential treatment, a priority when it comes to payment. And I think it is a very important step, because many small investors had their life saving in this exchange, and it's important that they get a preference over the larger or richer people. Furthermore, highlighted on the screen is also the preference settlement offer. What the exchange is currently proposing is that people who had withdrawn money from the exchange in a window of 9 days before the filing of bankruptcy might be asked to pay part of the money back. Now, this would not impact smaller customers, because it is very clearly mentioned that people who had withdrawn a net amount of more than $250,000 US dollars from the exchange will be asked to pay 15% of the net withdrawn amount from the exchange towards this case. Now, I am certain that most small customers would not get impacted if this current clause goes through as proposed. For those who had net withdrawal amount of more than $50,000, I will be covering this in greater details in the subsequent video, because the document also, the docket that has been provided on the official website gives various scenarios of withdrawals herein, and hence I will be covering it in details subsequently in a more detailed video later on. That is essentially what is covered in the summary. Now, I know there have been various fake news across on different topics on media. So please rest assured that this particular docket I'm taking care of, this article is the official release on the official crawl website. This is exhibit 2 of the docket that has been released. The docket number is 3291, which I will be linking to this video in the description section for your references. There are two other things that are not covered in the summary that I spoke just now, which are of importance. First is the illiquid investments. As I covered in one of my previous videos, link above again, FTX had made certain very important investments and some promising ventures like Anthropic. Now, Anthropic has received investments from Google and Amazon and is expected to be currently valued at around $6 billion. Current size of investment of FTX is not known. However, investments like this, which are currently illiquid, can help us to recover the full money back. Now, the treatment of this is mentioned in the docket and will be covered in the video that I make separately. However, the basic idea premise is that these investments will be made to pay in a gradual way. So the upfront settlement for customers might not get benefited. Also, one last thing that is important in the docket, in the detailed docket, not covered in the summary, is the proposal for restarting the FTX exchange overseas. So the exchange will not be operating in US. This was also covered in the video, which is on the top of the screen right now. If you want to look at a detailed discussion, please click on the link. Basically, FTX is proposing to restart, or at least look for partners to restart the exchange overseas, which is not for US customers. If this goes through, which is also been called, which people have been discussing as FTX2, if this proceeds, then it is highly likely that some customers like you and me might be given an option to opt in or opt out of equity share in the new company. Now, a similar thing had happened in Celsius bankruptcy case, wherein customers were given a choice of taking more amount of dollars, taking more amount of shares of the company a lesser amount of dollars, or third, taking equal number of shares as everybody else, all being offered, we can also expect to get a similar election option. I presume that this would be between 1st of March or and 31st of June. However, when the developments come across, I'll be keeping you posted. So please subscribe to the channel so that whenever these kind of developments happen, which require your action, I'll be highlighting and updating you. If you found this video useful, please like it and share it with your friends and families. Also, subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to stay posted on important developments in the current case. I wish you all the best, and thank you so much. I'll see you later in the next video. Thank you. Bye-bye.